So it seems some people are getting rejected from a major Bleach event. And what does this mean? And why? And is this bad news for Bleach? Well, we're about to delve deep really into this video because a lot of people also have asked me since December, since the last episode of the Bleach anime, is did Bleach do well? And this kind of correlates with that a little bit. And also, throughout the rest of the video, I'll be talking about my experience in Japan and how Bleach was handled there. So, if you don't mind, click that like, subscribe, hit the bell icon, all that good stuff, and hit a comment in the comment section down below. And let's get into it, shall we? So if you guys don't know, on May the 7th of this year, 2023, there is going to be a big Bleach event in commemoration of releasing the Blu-ray version and the DVD version of the Bleach Thousand Year Blood War anime. This is going to be at the Anime Hall Black and have the voice actors of Ichigo and Ishida Uryu involved as well, as you can see on screen. It's also on the Bleach website as well, so you know that it's all legit. Now, of course, the winners were chosen to mid-April, which is pretty much as of the uploading of this video, and a lot of people did in fact get rejected. And the funny thing is that this was for 1,500 potential winners. So why are people getting rejected? Now, as you can see on the tweets on screen right now, you can see that people who bought the Blu-ray or the DVD, some of them got rejected, such as, it's a pity I didn't have to win the launch event for Bleach. Seriously, how much do you have to earn in life to win a Bleach event? I seriously hate it, or I really hate it. I failed the Bleach entry lottery. Sorrow, I can't hold on anymore. Understandable, I feel that. Bleach's DVD talk event was rejected. And it's sad, honestly, it really is bad that these people are getting rejected, but, you know, if I was in their shoes, I would be pretty upset too and pretty downbeaten about it. But all is not bad, because if you think about it, if you're getting rejected for an event, that means there's no spaces left to accommodate you. Meaning that the 1,500 people that do get to attend have bought the Blu-ray or DVD box set. And what does that mean is that realistically, the DVD or Blu-ray wasn't a flop. And again, the first thing that comes to mind, it's not a slight change to man at all. But realistically, that Blu-ray release wasn't entirely that great. I think it sold, what, 1,200? And then it diminished from that point on. And that, to its credit, was just a singular Blu-ray release. It wasn't a special edition or anything like that in the slightest. It was a bog standard Blu-ray release. And that, in and of itself, failed in its own right, even though MAPPA don't really need to rely on Blu-ray sales, and it can rely on, obviously, licensing agreements with, like, Crunchyroll or whoever else wanted to put their hand in the cookie jar in terms of getting that license to stream. But it's just an example of how popular Chainsaw Man was in the West, or how popular Chainsaw Man was in general, and it failed its Blu-ray releases. Again, it doesn't rely on Blu-rays, it's just an example of the matter. But the context here, which makes everything so much more different, is that Bleach's Blu-ray is at least £150-160, so probably in dollars, $180 to $200, worth of a special edition, limited release, Blu-ray box set, which came with a lot, and it's big, and it's huge. And if you have 1,500 people buying that, that is a huge success. And yes, the people that did get rejected, I do want to thank you for letting us know that you got rejected, because it gives us some sort of idea or stipulation on whether the Bleach Blu-rays did in fact sell well. And honestly, going based off of this a little bit, I would say did extremely well if this is the opening records for that Blu-ray release. It could have been 2,000, it could have been 3,000, it could have even been 5,000. And you know, 5,000 times $200, it's not a number to sniff at in the slightest. So for those asking if the Bleach anime did successfully, we don't even know what Disney put into the part of, like, the bidding war, so to say, to bring it over to the US and Europe and other places. I think in Aniplex's mind, not only did it do good in the streaming servicing platforms, but doing well also in physical releases is really justifiable for Aniplex. And again, it's important that Bleach does extremely well, because even though we've got four cores kind of confirmed to us and it's green lit, if this keeps up that trajectory, we will get more in the future, because Aniplex likes money, TV Tokyo like money, and Shueisha like money. The bigger, the better that this gets from here on out. Gonna really look forward to more content and more just stuff in general. So big congratulations to these users. on screen right now. Vazinha Blood War, Hem release, commemorative event I won. Is it a dream? I'm so happy. What should I do? Will I be able to meet the voice actors? Isn't it dangerous? I think I used to have all the luck in my life. Thank you. I completely forgot that I applied for the event to talk for Bleach Blu-rays. I won. I won the Bleach event. I can meet Morita-san for the first time and Ichigo-san. Wait, I won the Bleach talk event. Meet Morita. For the first time, I'm so happy. So just a few things of like the good and the bad side of this situation. But overall, if you were to look at it from an outside perspective, it is very, very good. And I'm really generally excited to see what the opening sales is going to be looking like. And if you really think about it in context as well, I think to get into this lottery event, you had to specifically buy it off Animate as well, or you had to go in store and get it from Animate. I'm not quite sure, because it wasn't off Amazon or anything like that. So your limited amount to actually get into this lottery is extremely limited and very specific. So the fact that 1,500 people specifically went to Animate and specifically reserved it under Animate, I think is pretty good. So let's talk about my experience in Japan. If you guys hadn't known, for the last 2 weeks and some change, because I've been home for a good few days now, almost a week, the last 2 weeks I've been to Japan. And of course, though I didn't buy really much in terms of Bleach merch, and I went there for my kind of own soul searching purposes, of course I saw a lot of Bleach. Of course, I went to Animate, I went to Jump Stores, I went to Akihabara, all those generic touristy stuff as well. I didn't get to go to the Bleach Expo because that's pretty far away. But I want to kind of give my experience and context, and also talk about a little bit of the Bleach manga sales as well, for those that may be able to give some insight in the comment section down below. But I'll give you my take on it. Nothing again is concrete, but this is just my perception in regards to things. When I went to Japan, the main thing that was mainly pushed and sold really well over there, or the main focus of all the anime season per se, I mean, obviously in terms of advertisement, it was advertised in the new season, which was like Hell's Paradise and Oshinoko, which was amazing, by the way, might I add. Very misleading, but amazing nonetheless. And if you know why I say misleading, well, you know, I feel very gaslit for the main character of the series. But still, regardless of what, through my time there, there was some good advertisements. I think one of the first things I noticed when I got to Japan, and I did go to Akihabara, I think on the first or second day, was I noticed a massive billboard promoting the Bleach Vazinha Blood War Blu-rays. And I think this is pretty significant, because it wasn't just a small billboard, it wasn't just a small advertisement on like a train or something. This was, or even like an underground station, like this was like a pretty big billboard, to which you'll be able to see on screen right now. And truth be told, I didn't really see much Chainsaw Man either. You do see Chainsaw Man within Animate itself. They had like a little TV playing the openings and some little like stationary merch, but nothing again too out there. And to be honest with you, the same with Bleach. It was really weird to kind of experience this, because I found that there was more merchandise in 2017 and 18 when I'd gone to Japan before in comparison to now. And when you go to like the average Jump Store or average Animate, it's like you do have a small portion of each series, except if you were like Spy Family or Haikyuu, then that stuff was like shilled a lot. So that was interesting. And of course, I guess My Hero as well. My Hero is still pretty big as well. But yeah, Bleach and Chainsaw Man had their own little small sections of merchandise, to which I did find weird. But something I did find quite interesting is that above the Bleach section of advertisements or merchandise, sorry, there was the advertisement for the Bleach Blu-ray. And everywhere that you saw, it was really shilling the fact of like reservations here, reservations here. So in context, and I'll talk about the manga portion as well in a bit, but in context, when I think about Bleach merchandise and when I think about the shilling of the Blu-ray, chances are what I'm thinking is a lot of the merchandise or the shilling of Bleach merchandise will be more so pushed when that Blu-ray comes out, because I feel like it is like a little teaser. It is like saying, hey, this thing's coming out, and they're kind of saving all that marketing push for when that Blu-ray comes out. Now, of course, you can look at the other side and look at the Jump Stores, which, again, for Jump Stores, there was Bleach here and there, and there's multiple Jump Stores. So, but a lot of them, or a lot of the main ones, such as like in Shinjuku, such as Akihabara, some of the stuff like that, there was very little Bleach merch. And in my kind of maybe copium, or even context, I guess you could say, is that I imagine most of the Bleach merch, because I've seen this with a few exhibits as well, is that I believe that all the Bleach merch that usually would be sold in Animates or in Jump Stores has all been moved over to the Bleach Expedition. And that would make more sense to put it all over there, where it is more garnered to a target for Bleach, rather than have it all in different locations where at the exhibit it might sell out rather than you've got all this merch elsewhere across the country, but they're not selling out as they would at the expo. So I feel like that's been more prioritized at the exhibits, to have merchandise there rather than across all these broad spectrums. Unless you want to like mass produce a bunch of Bleach merch, which maybe would or wouldn't not kind of make sense. But again, I'm not the guy that plans product management, so who knows. But that's kind of my perspective on it, and of course I could be completely wrong, and maybe it just doesn't sell, or maybe it's not their focus, because Spy Family and My Hero seem to be the main focus. Even going into the jump stores and seeing not much Chainsaw Man either, and it is quite fascinating that Chainsaw Man and Bleach had very limited amounts of merchandise throughout all these spectrums, and I had to really question why. But nonetheless, that's kind of the situation of Bleach right now. It's getting the promotion, it's getting the promotion on TV as well. In terms of the merchandise, I couldn't really tell you what's really the plan now or what's really going on. Maybe there's some that's being produced right now, who knows. Maybe it's all going to the exhibit, who knows. But then let's talk about the Bleach manga sales, and a lot of people are wondering why the Bleach manga sales haven't had a boost in popularity, or why it hasn't had the 150 million plus that we all expected it to. And I want to give a little bit of context to that, because I do see, again, a lot of people on Twitter say some dumb things. So the focus right now, what I've noticed at Animate or even Jump Stores or any really other bookstore that I walked into, is that the focus seems to be less about the Bleach volumes. And again, the promotion for Bleach volumes was there. However, the Bleach volumes that have been really shielded and really put front, face and center, and I'll show some pictures on screen as well to give you an idea, is the Bleach remixes. And if you don't know what the Bleach remixes are, it's like big omnibus versions of like good quality, but there's more volumes in one. Point is, the weird thing about these volumes, from what I've again researched online, and I couldn't really give you a full concrete answer, is that these volumes, or Bleach Remix volumes, don't count towards the overall Bleach volume sales. Because, and you might even say, oh well, Slam Dunk had a big popularity when it had its recover designs. Yeah, but those were still the volumes in its singles, just with different covers. In this case for Bleach, it's not the same as the volumes, it's more so a differented, edited, condensed, or maybe squashed version. Again, I couldn't really explain it, but these volumes don't get classed towards the Oricon sales, and thus are kind of their own separate beings. I couldn't really get any numbers per se. Maybe I didn't look hard enough. But yeah, those are the things that are getting shilled currently at the moment. And if you want to argue as well that they do and they just don't sell very well in general, and they have low views and that's why they don't really get counted, well, the other argument on the other side of the fence is, well, when it came to marketing the Bleach anime, a lot of the Bleach manga, especially through like ZBrek and other online platforms where you could read manga in Japan, is that Bleach had so much of a long promotion of maybe even 2 years of just you can read Bleach completely for free on these platforms. That was the push, and that was the marketing strategy going forward for Bleach. And I think it made sense, because the eyes of Shueisha were not really worried about Bleach's backlog selling. What we want is for people to catch up, so they will be watching the Thousand Year Blood War. And I feel like that was more important, to have more eyes on Bleach and people be more familiar with Bleach, rather than making all these people invest all this time and money into buying these volumes and never get into the Thousand Year Blood War arc, other than giving it for free, letting people just have everything for free so they can watch that anime. And I feel like that was probably more of the smarter move going forward. So in terms of like, oh well, why hasn't Bleach volume sales gone up, is because realistically for the past year and two, it's been read for free. People haven't needed to buy it. And that makes more sense, because as long as the anime does well, I think that that's really important as well, because again, you can sell more merch later on that will probably justify the volumes not selling or having a bigger push as some might have expected. So yeah, you guys can stop asking me if the Bleach anime did well or not. I'll give you my perception. I'll give you some examples and some evidence suggesting why I think it did do well. Of course, I'm excited to see more of the TV Tokyo fiscal reports later on down the future, and I'm also interested to see also what the before and afters of the Blu-rays to TV version. Of course, we saw a little bit within the new Bleach music video where Ichigo had his clothes all tattered in comparison to the TV version, so we know that there's going to be corrections, and I will absolutely be doing a video on those corrections and kind of doing some comparisons and seeing what I like more. But so far, looks great. Other than that, some of your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think of everything. And get excited for more Bleach content coming up, because we have quite a lot of ideas coming through. So, there's some marketing of Bleach. I'm going to catch you guys out. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hudson, as always, people. Focus. Peace out.